जुबिन नौटियाल ने ये गाना गाया है। एक तो बहुत ही लकी सिंगर हैं, लेकिन उनका ये पहला बड़ा वीडियो है और उनके बारे में मैं कहने के लिए बुलाना चाहूँगा मंच पे मेरे दोस्त, मेरे बड़े भाई और इस फिल्म के निर्देशक निर्माता संजय गुप्ता जी। वेलकम सर।
थैंक यू।
फर्स्टली कंग्रेचुलेशंस ऑन योर ट्रेलर हिटिंग द 5.6 मिलियन मार्क। और आपको एक बात और बता दूं कि पहले ही 24 घंटे में ट्रेलर लॉन्च के बाद इट हिट 2 मिलियन इन 24 आवर्स, ब्रेकिंग ऑल रिकॉर्ड्स ऑफ एनी इंडियन सिनेमा एवर। इट ऑल्सो ब्रोक वन ऑफ आर फेवरेट फिल्म बजरंगी भाईजान्स रिकॉर्ड ऑफ 1.8 मिलियन, व्हिच इज नो मीन फीट। संजय,
वेल आई गेस इट जस्ट टेल्स अस द एंटीसिपेशन फॉर द फिल्म एंड द लव दैट इज ऑलरेडी देयर। एंड वन अदर थिंग बिफोर आई proceed with this, I want to tell you all why Rohit is here.
Yeah,
he is my younger brother and there's a small story behind this. Kante film humne LA mein banayi thi aur Kante ka pehla look jab humne Lands End hotel mein usko dikhaya tha sabko, so that's when Rohit and me met and Rohit had come and compared that evening and so I can say he's my lucky charm.
Yes, absolutely. And I hope that luck takes this forward. Kante went on to become a cult classic, as we all know. But I think that with Jazba, White Feather is going to have another feather in its cap. And to talk about this song, I'd like to start with you, Sanjay. Tell us something about the song, what it is like, before we call up Jubin.
See, this song in the film comes in the end credits. Usually in the end credits, people like thumpy, fast-paced, that kind of stuff, but we wanted to go against that type and opted for melody, great lyrics, great arrangement, and that's what this is.
Okay. तो इससे पहले कि हम जुबिन को यहाँ पर बुलाएं आपके सामने उसे अनवेल करने के लिए, should we call upon the lady first?
Yes. Absolutely.
दोस्तों, इस फिल्म में बहुत सारी खासियतें हैं, लेकिन एक खास बात यह है कि इस फिल्म के साथ एक ऐसी अभिनेत्री अपना कमबैक कर रही हैं जिन्होंने हिंदुस्तान को ऑलरेडी झंझोड़ के रख दिया है कई सालों से। शी इज बीन रूलिंग हार्ट्स एंड ऑफ कोर्स अनुराधा, यू बीन रूलिंग आवर हार्ट्स, बट द लेडी इन क्वेश्चन हुज बीन रूलिंग एवरीबॉडीज हार्ट नॉट ओनली इन इंडिया बट अक्रॉस द ग्लोब, द वेरी ब्यूटिफुल, द वेरी टैलेंट, पुट योर हैंड्स टुगेदर फॉर ऐश्वर्या राय बच्चन, लेडीज एंड जेंटलमैन। वेरी वेरी वार्म वेलकम ऐश्वर्या। So here she is, and this is going to be your comeback, and everybody is waiting with bated breath. But today I want to ask you a question. Of course, you'll be answering various questions to the press about the film later. But I'd like to know, what was your experience shooting this song, being part of this song, Bandhya?
Good evening, and thank you for the welcome. Sorry, I was talking to Dada backstage, and I didn't realize I had been already welcomed on. So excuse the second of the delay. Well, I already said it at the trailer launch, and I should repeat, working with Sanjay, firstly, has been an absolute pleasure. And as Irfan had put it at the trailer launch, Jazba is a Sanjay Gupta film. So what was the word he used? Sanjay Gupta-fied or Sanjay-centric and so on and so forth. What would the term be? But that's it. That's the movie, and that's the energy with which we have come on board and thoroughly enjoyed the journey, the ride actually. Lots of blazing wheels, lots of dust, lots of car rides, and lots of adrenaline. And it's wonderful to tell such an intense story with that kind of pace and that kind of, to feel time ticking throughout the narrative has been really enjoyable, and I'm so glad we have been meaning to work together for so long. So if we have come together, it's on this one. And while Sanjay has candidly shared that, you know, this is we haven't done the predictable signature stuff as expected in the regular narrative. He's kept the treatment of the music as would be true to the narrative of a film of such a subject. We absolutely love this song, and we thought it would be fun to throw in a video, but not in the conventional, predictable way yet again. So still staying true to the spirit of the film, the character of the film, and yet giving in that little dash of chutzpah. And working with Emma after so long again was wonderful, and Zubin's really rendered the song beautifully. So call the rest of the team on board.
Okay. Ahmed, can we have you here? I'm going to call the rest of the team a little later. But since you mentioned Ahmed, Ahmed is with us.
Here's my partner in crime.
And may I call upon Zubin. Zubin Nautiyal, the voice behind this lovely, lovely song.
And most importantly, Amjad and Nadeem, the music directors. Can you have Nadeem and Amjad here, please?
Sanjay, please tell us something about the shooting of this video. Anybody can shoot a video, but you guys need to tell us something about the video itself.
I think Ahmed and me, whenever we work, the one thing we never do is any homework. There's nothing planned. Whatever comes out instinctively. It's from the heart, and that's what is there. There are no rehearsals and there's no storyboarding.
Ahmed, would you like to add something there?
Lots of spontaneity. That is Sanjay's language, actually. Lots of spontaneity.
Well, that's true. You know, his pet name is Gops. So, you know, we never have anything planned, but we have a kind of, we're like cockroaches. We've got these antennas and the vibration comes through. And secondly, I shoot with many heroines and many heroes, everybody, but let me tell you, that when Gups was on one camera and I was on the other, and when you have somebody like her, so it's done. So hum to sirf shoot karte rahe, baki jo inhone kiya hai. So ye best hai jo batayengi.
Aishwarya, would you like to join and tell us your feelings when you shot this song? Because it's obviously not a regular song. The feel is...
So, like we were saying, like Gups confessed that everything, you know, is very spontaneous, and luckily I've found an incredible comfort level already with him during the making of this movie, and we have common friends in the business, so it was working with him has really been easy, very, very natural. And I've known Ahmed forever, I mean right since Tal, and meaning to do so much more over the years. We still have time ahead, which is a great thing. So it was wonderful reconnecting again, and they've sung the song. He sung the song so beautifully. They have composed it so, I mean, arranged it so beautifully. So that was pretty easy, because the brief from both Sanjay and Ahmed was to feel the song and to be true to it. So while this will get labeled a video, nothing in this movie is keeping with the labels. It'll get labeled a comeback film like you just did, thanks, yet again. But we're not playing to that adage. Likewise, we're not playing to the perception of a video could, would, should be. It wasn't about, come on, let's do the moves, let's throw in a move here, because guess what, there's Ahmed, and guess what, that's me, and guess what, he can really make it look amazingly cool. But we still stay true. So that was really nice that we all are on the same page there. And it was about feeling the song and bringing that to the camera.
Thank you very much. And since we've spoken so much about the song, thank you Aishwarya for being here. Thank you Emma. Thank you guys. Thank you Sanjay. Zubin, I'd like you to stay back.
He can sing.
Yeah.
He is singing.
My friend Sachin Joshi, please on stage. Aiyah Nitin ji, bahut bahut swagat. Sachin, welcome. Akash ji, aiyah. I'd also now like to call the entire cast back on stage. Aishwarya, can we have you back one more time, please? Aishwarya. Ma'am, come here. Aap log har press meet mein mujhse poochte hain ki main itna stylish kyun. Uski wajah bahar khadi hai. May I call upon stage the original tiger, Jackie Shroff. The dadas of all dada, who's probably making himself appear. Woo! We have two bright young talents with us today. We also have Abhimanyu Singh. Abhimanyu, please come on stage. Dada, welcome. Abhimanyu, we have Priya Banerjee and Siddhant Kapoor. Priya is making her debut with this film. And Siddhant, who's a powerhouse performer, welcome. Ahmed, can we have you back for the photo op? Aap idhar aaiye yaar, main to film hoon nahi. I'd like to also call Vardhaman and Rishabh, who have been very, very kind to have organized this for us. Rishabh, Vardhaman, please. Thank you. The two stylish brothers behind Escobar. And that's it. Now before, thank you very much, all you guys. And all the very best to Team Jazba. And I'm sure it's going to take everything a notch higher. Lekin hum logon ne shuruaat mein, thank you dada. Dada, before you go, a few words.
हाँ ब्रो, पहले तो सबको बहुत बहुत प्यार. आप लोग इतने आए ले इतना बड़ा फोर्स के अंदर, अच्छा लगा. जज्बा ब्रो, हिंदुस्तान है, जज्बा तो होगा. अगर जज्बा नहीं होगा तो क्या होगा? अपन थोड़ी ठंडे खून के लोग हैं, सब हॉट ब्लडेड है, सब गर्म खून है. ऐश्वर्या बाबा का पिक्चर है, बहुत अच्छा काम किया. मैंने डबिंग करते वक्त देखा, हमारे हिंदुस्तान की सबसे खूबसूरत, सबसे टैलेंटेड बच्ची है. She is a beautiful girl. I worked with her. She started a career in Albela. I was there. Albela picture mein main tha. Aur main kyunki ye inke hone ke baad koi dikhta nahi hai. Bolne ka matlab hai ki bahut dam hai aur solid perform kiya hua hai. Pura jazbati role hai. Jazba title Sanjay Baba ne jo rakha hai, sahi rakha hai baba. Sanjay, bloody good. I think you have a fantastic film. I think you have performed superb, Ash. You look lovely, always you look lovely, and you'll perform fantastic. All the best to everybody. Aapko bhi, aur aap sabko bhi bhulu. Zyada kuch bolunga nahi. Mera bachcha bana hua hai badmash. Baaki kuch bolunga nahi. Bolne ka apna kaam nahi hai aaj. Aaj in logon ka kaam hai, ye bolenge. Ye hai ki jazba, Hindustan mein jazba ke siwa kuch nahi hai, bhulu.
Thank you. I'd like to request Nitin Kenny sir, Akash and Sachin to say a few words.
Good evening, everyone. Finally, mixed emotions. Excited भी हम लोग काफी और थोड़ा सा मुझे nervousness feel हो रहा है क्योंकि मेरे लिए ये पहला as a producer first time I'm doing something. And Sanjay has done a fantastic job with the film Jazba. Ashwarya ji has done a fantastic job. I've seen the film. I think definitely it will excite the audience of India. Thank you.
It's a great privilege to be here, and it's a proud moment for us all at Zee, because after such a long time we have two global stars, we have a fantastic stylized director of the country, and we have a tremendous team in terms of the producer, the Sanjay Gupta, Akash, Sachin ji, all of us. And it's been a great pleasure to make this film, and I am sure you'll enjoy the film as well. Thank you.
Thank you very much and all the very best, Team Jazba. Please. Or okay, can we just have the star cast for a bit, please? You guys can. Aja. Dada, dada. Thank you, Sarim. Thank you very much. Thank you, Dada. Thank you, Ashwarya. Thank you, Abhimanyu. And guys, since everybody is here and we are a little greedy, ek isse pehle, Dada, Dada doesn't want to go solo.
I think you can expect a very entertaining and thrilling film. It's a very taut screenplay, it's a thriller and not really in the mold of the formula films that we've been seeing of late. In any case, I've never made those kind of films. And as far as Aishwarya is concerned and I am concerned, I guess yeah, it is after a while, but then at the end of the day, it's just another day at work. There's not been any delays as such. We're well within our timetable and the schedule that we plan to do. And in any case, we're just doing a curtain raiser at Cannes. We're not showing the film as such. It won't be premiering, just a curtain raiser. It's not difficult. We have a great script. Every time we sent it out to any of the actors, my brief to my casting director, Hanithran, was very simple that I needed the best of the best. I said, just get me the best talent in the business. And a lot of actors like Abhimanyu Singh, Chandan Sanyal, Atul Kulkarni, I have pulled in personal favors from them because even though the length of the role may not be very big, but they play very important characters. Hamari koshish hai film September tak release karne ke liye. September mein plan hai. Shooting khatam ho jayegi March April mein, aur uske baad mein post production and then release. इस फिल्म की पूरी शूटिंग बॉम्बे में है. फिल्म बॉम्बे बेस्ड है. प्रेजेंट बॉम्बे, प्रेजेंट डे बॉम्बे. सो इट्स जस्ट गोइंग टू बी ऑल ओवर बॉम्बे.
मेरा निष्कर्ष यह है पढ़ने के बाद कि अगर आपने फिल्म सेवन देखी है तो सेवन में जो केविन स्पेसी जैसा उस तरह का साइकोलॉजी है मेरे रोल का फ्रॉम मिस्टर गुप्ता एंड माई को एक्टर्स. But so that's why I'm carrying my diary and pen to take down notes and everything. Since I come from theaters, I have a lot of questions. So hopefully I'll get the answers and start preparing on it. Actually, I was quite jubilant and if I can say exhilarated because the kind of films Mr. Gupta makes is like with which they are very stylish and yet dipped in core of Indian Hindi cinema. For me, it's a new opportunity because where I come from, because since whatever I have done, I have probably excelled in thrillers like D-Day or Kamine. So this is like sort of in the same genre, but a little more stylish and a little more crispy. Yeah, so I'm looking forward to it. So I finished Jazba. I start working on Love Affair by Sony Razdan with Arjun and Kalki. So that will be my next film. Yeah.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Very excited to work with a cast and crew like this, and it's Sanjay Gupta sir. So it's basically my first director, so I'm very excited to play a part. It's a very dark character, and yeah, it's very Ash's comeback film, so yeah, I'm very happy to be a part of it. Yeah. I think this is a film which Sanjay sir has been wanting to do for a very long time, something like this, not very commercial, very performance oriented, and with a very ensemble, subtle cast like this. I think he's given every character a individual niche in this. So even a person with one scene, three scenes will be noticed in this film.
For sure.
All the best. Go and win the World Cup, please. Again. Okay? Chalo. Thank you.
Really exciting because of the cast, because of the director, and I'm working for the first time with Sanjay ji, so really looking forward to it. The story is extremely good. It is different, and whatever makes an actor exciting after listening to the story has that.
Well, yes, Happy New Year to everybody, and thank you so much for coming today. We are here, the team of Jazba, having our initial readings together as a team, and I'm very excited to work with Sanjay.
After Bizarres, how in Jazba, so how excited are you to work with Sanjay? Because he had an approach through Abhishek first, and he said, because he was just trying to come to you directly, that he approached Abhishek first, then he came to you.
I think no, it's not any other reason. I think what tends to happen is I'm obviously, justifiably and completely besotted with my Aradhya, and I keep telling everybody in the business ki that's a lifelong thing. Na kal ki baat hai, na aaj ki baat hai, wo to hamesha ki baat rahegi. And I think what he did was, of course, he gauged with Abhishek if I'm ready now to actually go on the floors with the movie, because jaise ki main 3 saal se aap logon ke saath interact kar rahi hoon, aur main kehti gayi hoon ki main scripts padh rahi hoon aur aage jaake shuru karungi, lekin wo aage kafi aage badhta gaya, and I lost track of time, completely blissed out in motherhood, and glad on it. I'm very very glad on the time I have fruitfully spent with Aradhya, and so I think Sanjay checked with Abhishek if you're ready, and I said yes, and Abhishek told him yes.
Absolutely.
I mean that's not even a question. We're here working together. I love his work, and I'm very very excited and looking forward to Jazba with the entire team. That's not the way I look at it. It's about a film and what you need to prepare for it, and it's the director's call, what they're looking for in their character, and that's what you deliver to as an actor.
You're looking fabulous.
Thank you.
Yeah.
It is an adaptation of a foreign language film, but what it is what we're not talking about. We're contractually bound.
आपने क्या ब्रीफ दिया था मिस बच्चन को, किस तरह से उनको कैरेक्टर में आना है?
जितना कुछ नहीं, जो जो फिल्म की स्क्रिप्ट है वो उनके पास है, जो फिल्म का किरदार है वो डिटेल में डिस्कस किया है, एंड शी इज वर्क अकॉर्डिंगली ऑन इट. No, no, it's not about that. It's just that we are excited about anything. Every time you start a new venture, new film, you know, there is a certain level of excitement. And for me, officially, the journey begins today. From here on, we start our first reading, and the next 5 days, we start shooting. And then we go on. It's why I'm happy that the locations are Bombay, and QK film, period film, nahi hai, like my previous film. So it is Bombay today. And Bombay today is Mumbai today, contemporary Mumbai today, with its all new skyline. And all the new architecture and everything, so that is something I'm looking forward to shooting. Film ki shooting April mein khatam ho jayegi, June mein curtain raiser hai aur September mein release hai.
What special appearance Mr. Bachchan ki, Abhishek ki?
Ji nahi, kisi ki nahi. There no special appearance. Thank you.
I can only smile modestly. You're paying me a compliment, and it would be very rude of me to accept it all as humility. It's for you to make the conclusion. I read the script. I read the script, and I like the script. That's why I'm doing the play. Not allowed to speak about it.
Yes, I'm looking forward to working with Sanjay Gupta after 18 years. And of course with Ash and Irfan, I'll be working strangely for the first time, and I'm looking forward to this film. It's an amazing script, and I don't want to call it Ashwara's comeback film. The people, actors never go, they just take a break, and we're looking forward to this basically.
So, are you fond of Sanjay Gupta's movies or his film?
I like his movies. I like the way he directs it. I like, he's a very stylish director, and this time he's chosen a script which is based on a Korean film. I've seen the Korean film. I've read the script also. I think it's going to be fun. There are certain chapters in life you like to forget. Me being chairman of Censor Board, I've left behind me, and I think any film which has been sent to revising committee, I think is on the discretion of the Censor Board, and I think they have to decide how they should deal with this film.
Sir, but one thing I would like to say, sir, thank you so much for telling us that we get a cancellation of 7 games. Because sir, you're suddenly speaking.
Maybe I was not supposed to say that. But, thank you.
Yes, Jasbaz starts today and I think hopefully the shooting would start in another week's time. And this would be my new role probably, producing a film. And it's a great thing to produce with Sanjay. It's a great script and I think amazing cast. And Nitinji is here. And I think we're going to have lots of fun with Jasbaz.
But are you going to act also with
Jasbaz? No. I'm just producing this film and because I really enjoy the script and I feel it's going to be one of a kick-ass thriller and an amazing action film.
For SL Vision, which is doing very well in Marathi cinema, would like to really now take off in Hindi as well. So I am very excited. You know what the mainstream film budgets are like today, you know. So it's going to be nothing less than any mainstream cinema budget. So you can imagine. Okay. So you can say that this film is going to be in the range of about 30-40 crores, whatever that normal budgets are. And we're just starting off because we are still planning quite a lot of things. As far as fees are concerned, let me tell you, Aishwarya is definitely charging less than what she normally charges. And although we don't discuss commercial aspects with the media as such, and she's very excited about the project, and there is no question of charging more just because she has a comeback or anything. It's the excitement of the project that's brought up to this film.
Jasbaz ko definitely bahut badi opening milegi kyunki of course Sanjay Gupta coming back after Vadala and Aishwarya has come back after a long time and after Guzarish, and she's very excited about the film and we all are excited. I mean, that's the reason we all are on board with this project. So we hope a huge opening for the film. Well, it's matlab on a good day Dabang would open on a big number, on a bad day another film which is good but may not open to a big number. So it's all about timing and release and everything. So it depends karta hai, but we definitely expect a huge opening.
Thank you.
Yeah, it's again a reminder how our selection panel was so kind of the film. They didn't send it for the Oscars, but the film is finding its own way, and making its presence felt all around the world. And BAFTA is special for me because the first film, my first film which won the award was BAFTA. I went with Warrior for BAFTA, and Warrior won 2 awards. So. Netball के बारे में I can't say anything right now. The films which I have completed is Madari with Nishikant, Piku with Sujit Sarkar in Noida. I'll definitely talk about in detail my experience with Mr. Bachchan, and it was special. And I never imagined in my life that I'll be facing a camera with him, sharing the screen with him, and it was one of the memorable experience. And once we start publicizing Piku, then I'll talk it in detail what was my experience.
Reading a book when he met up with me and very nonchalantly took me through a two-liner of a film. And when we heard the film and we saw what he had in mind, we never knew that the journey would come up to this. So we are exhilarated by this particular journey, and to share the jazba of the man himself, I call upon the captain of the ship, the director, story writer, screenplay, blah blah blah, Mr. Sanjay Gupta. We're going to call that quirky pairing on the stage, the two people who have made this jazba what this jazba has become. One person who's going to be entering right now, I don't want to really introduce her. It's not my right to introduce her. But let me just say that she's taken India internationally. She's one of the chief contributors to being one of the best brand ambassadors for this particular country. And the chief protagonist of Jazba, Mrs. Aishwarya Rai Bachchan.
Hello.
And along with her, I would like to call one of the most stalwart actors that we have in Indian cinema today, and the biggest international star, Sir Irfan Khan. Starcast is here, the entire team is here. We are very, very eager to get your responses and all the questions to the two immensely cool and thrilling pair. We are now open. Please.
I wanted to ask you, what made you say, yes, this is the film that I want to do?
It was an instant yes and an easy yes. And the what will be answered when you watch the movie. Very, very obviously. I'm sure y'all can already get the feel of it with the trailer. The subject itself is fabulous because it's a wonderful thriller of a story. It speaks about a lot of things on a lot of different levels. Very, very relevant, very, very important, very, very meaningful. And it's the absolute language of one's heart. So it was an easy yes, and that coupled with the maker itself and the incredible team, beginning here with, of course, Irfan, as you see, but an incredible team that we have brought on board. So it was our, it was an immediate wish list, I think when Sanjay and me were sitting together and going through the script, this is the cast that we saw. And when that actually comes true, being thankful is an understatement for the entire team. So as an actor and as an artist, I was just so grateful that all the actors consented and came on board, because that's just the way we saw it. And it's been a superlative experience. I think I've answered all the million questions possible today, but yeah.
A big congratulations to the whole team of Jazba. A big congratulations to you. The trailer is very fantastic. My question to you is, Aishwarya ma'am, during your absence, there was a time when a revolution came where many women-centric movies were not only critically successful, but they were many commercial successful also. So what do you want to say about it? And do you think that Jazba also will be the part of that revolution?
Wow. Suddenly he reminds me of an absence. So because very honestly, I haven't felt it. I haven't felt being absent, though obviously, I mean, going by time and the number of releases that we do have, of course, I wasn't making movies. But a lot of the ladies here will nod and who've completely experienced what I am wonderfully experiencing right now. We have no concept of time and we don't realize how time flies by. So being a working mother, I really did not delve into this absence factor, and probably that's why I have not necessarily focused on the comeback term. There's no going away from it, there's no running away from it, and there's it will forever be the comeback film. So I'm not denying it, but when I turn around and say that I haven't felt it, that's just the way it is. And when you're talking about subjects and movies getting their due, it's always the audience's verdict. And it would be wonderful if the world wouldn't view it as we artists do. That is, we don't really, I think, and I'm daring to speak even on your behalf, Irfan, I mean, you please contribute. But I don't think we get into a movie compartmentalizing it as any kind of centric. You know, I mean, really, the dash centric. Because here we are just coming on board, having a story unfold and being told to the viewer. And I honestly believe even viewers don't necessarily label it, but I think once that impression is kind of set, then that's the way it gets articulated. So we are here making movies, and we are always in the hope that every movie that we make appeals to the audience, the viewer, because that's who it's being made for. And that's pretty much as innocent as our entire approach is, I think, when we make movies. But subjects of variety today are being obviously appreciated, enjoyed by the audience, and accessible to a wider, more receptive audience. And that makes it a very exciting time for us in the movies, as in all of us here, be it the producers, the directors, the writers, the actors. I think it's an exciting time in cinema, and that we as the creative people are very grateful for, because it just makes our time more, we get to enjoy a variety as well.
Sanjay Gupta, you know, and Sanjay Gupta, when Sanjay Gupta is directing a film, is Sanjay Gupta centric film?
Absolutely.
Sanjay sir, this movie is it a remake of a South Korean movie, 7 Days? Because the storyline is quite similar with that.
It is a remake. I'm not at a liberty to tell you what film it is, but it is a remake of a Korean film.
So have you directly lifted the movie, and especially in the basis of the violence?
It has been adapted.
I can tell you one thing. I have not seen any movie when I have come on board to do this movie. We have received a script and we have done a Sanjay Gupta film. As clear as that.
My question is, how did you play a lawyer in this role? How challenging was it? And what did you prepare for this role?
जी, आपने सही पहचाना कि मैं पहली बार एक लॉयर का किरदार निभा रही हूँ. तो ऑब्वियसली इट डिड एंटेल अ सर्टेन डिग्री ऑफ एजुकेटिंग वन सेल्फ अबाउट रियली व्हाट द लाइफ ऑफ अ लॉयर इज लाइक, व्हाट मी एंड संजय शेयर अबाउट व्हाट द रियल सीन इज लाइक. क्योंकि कहीं ना कहीं हम लोग की जो इम्प्रेशंस हैं, एंड वंडरफुली सो, आई थिंक दैट्स व्हाई वी ऑलवेज से सिनेमा इज अ पार्ट ऑफ आर कल्चर. Because we virtually grow up believing that's the way life is. So we do have a certain impression of what a courtroom scenario is from cinema that we have enjoyed watching for years. And that is somewhere, if none of us have had absolute first-hand experiences legally, which God bless all of us here, hopefully not too many, then that remains our impression. But Sanjay obviously gave a deeper insight into what the real scenario is, and we wanted to keep it as real as we could. And that's the way we have played it out, with the conviction of a lawyer, with not necessarily the dramatics that you would. We let the moment have its drama rather than the way you're playing out the moment. I think that was a very important brief that Sanjay shared with us, and that's what we try to stay truest to.
She called him an international star. She's no less an international star. Now, with two international stars, how did you blend the international appeal with the Indian appeal? And do you think this is the film that will make the much anticipated breakthrough in world cinema?
Make any claims that, you know, we're making a film to cross the borders and this and that, but there is an intention in place. There are cuts of the film being readied. It's being dubbed and released widely all across the UAE. It's being dubbed in Arabic. We're also dubbing it in other South American languages and English. So there are international cuts with a slightly shorter length that will be going out, apart from the obvious diaspora release.
Sorry, I'd like to add to that. Sir, hum national hi national hai. Bahut hi national hai. It's just that jab bhi kai baar mujhe introduce kiya jata hai, to ya to Miss World ko reference hoti hai, ya wo international beauty title ka reference hota hai, ya international presence ka reference hota hai. To isliye maine kaha ki bhai, I'm very, very thankful for the opportunities destiny has given me. But honestly and very, very truly, as you all see, I'm not the only fortunate one. And that is why I made that reference there. But when we did this film, we were happy as actors to come on board. And it isn't about all the adages that go with it.
For you to play a cop role from that of Good Day with all the punchlines.
I didn't think of cop at all. I was thinking of punchlines. And you know, it's a Sanjay Gupta film, and I had great time, saying those punchlines. My attraction was at punchlines. You know, I wanted to deal with punchlines, and I love them sometimes. You know, and in this film there are a few, and you will remember them when you come out to the theater. It'll make your life colorful. My punchlines. My favorite is there. I don't know whether I should reveal them now or no. Okay. There's a point where one of my guy asks, "Ke Aishwarya comes and meets me, and she goes away, and he asks, 'Tumne jaane diya?' He says, 'Mohabbat thi isliye jaane diya. Zid hoti to baahon mein hoti.'"
Aishwarya, इस साइड में हाँ, दोबारा वापसी पर आपके सामने संजय गुप्ता जैसे डायरेक्टर और इधर इरफान जैसे एक्टर, तो किस तरह की स्पेशल तैयारियां करनी पड़ी आपको या सीधे मैदान में उतर गए?
आप इनसे पूछिए
नहीं, आप ही बताइए ना।
जहाँ तक काम का सवाल है तो सीधे मैदान पे ही उतर आए, लेकिन जो नॉर्मल जो हमारी प्रेपरेशन होती है, मीटिंग्स होती है, ऑब्वियसली आई मीन ये नहीं कि कल बोले और आज जाग गए और सेट पे गए, तो जो नॉर्मल हमारी प्रोफेशनल जो प्रेपरेशंस होती है वो तो रही ही, लेकिन सच पूछे तो इसलिए हम यही कहते हैं कि आई थिंक यू नो कई सालों से हम ये सुने हैं हमारे सीनियर्स को कहते हुए कि वंस एन आर्टिस्ट ऑलवेज एन आर्टिस्ट, एंड दैट डेफिनेटली रिंग्स ट्रू एंड आई एम विटनेस टू इट विद माई ओन पर्सनल एक्सपीरियंस, क्योंकि कोई समय का गैप हो या ना हो उसका हमें हम उसे नहीं पहचानते, और जो कला है एक कलाकार को उसे निभाने में ही जो संतुष्टि मिलती है, जो खुशी मिलती है, वो तो एक बहुत ही गहरी बात है, और उसे लफ्ज़ में उतारना बहुत मुश्किल है, लफ्ज़ों में उतारना। सो आई थिंक दैट्स द सिंपलेस्ट ऑनेस्ट वे आई कुड से इट।
बच्चन साहब मेरी ज़िंदगी आसपास बहुत घूम रहे हैं, मैंने बहुत उनकी फिल्में देखी थी, उनकी फिल्में देख के मैं बड़ा हुआ, ऐसा दौर आया कि वो आसपास बहुत हैं, मैं कुछ एप्लीकेशन डाली है मैंने कि वो मुझे अडाप्ट कर लें, अभी तक अप्रूव हुई नहीं है, होगी तो बताऊंगा मैं आपको।
यू हैव कॉन्स्टेंटली प्रूव एवरीवन रॉन्ग एंड यू कॉन्स्टेंटली डू वर्सेटाइल रोल्स एंड थिंग्स, नाउ रिसेंटली ऑल्सो डिड अ पार्टी सॉन्ग, सो डू यू डू दैट कॉन्शियसली एंड डू यू कॉन्स्टेंटली ट्राई टू रीइन्वेंट योरसेल्फ एंड डू एंड यू नो गो बियॉन्ड योर लिमिट्स?
I think what you're saying is right. Actually, I proved myself also wrong, and nobody thought I could become an actor. I also never thought I could become an actor, but there was a kind of a drive which propelled me to do this. And there's an instinct in me which hates formality, which tries to see things in right definitions. You know, whatever. I think I'm here to redefine things, I hate conventional things. So it's an instinct, it's not very thought out thing, It's something which comes from inside me, If there is a formal atmosphere, there will be an instinct within me which will try to disrupt it, So it's a God-given curse or, blessing, I don't know.
You had to change that too. He didn't want to say God-given blessing, God-given shared curse. Just let's just say that differently. Saying the same thing, but let's say it differently.
Aishwarya?
I guess I'll be now sounding similar to him, that I probably don't fall into the conventional responses and reactions that people are seeking, and then they focus on the giggle. Like, I now realize I just did a second ago. See, the point is, I have always enjoyed the process of the making of the film. That's what's most precious to me, because that's what I live with. That's my life. That's my everyday. And I have said this for years. It's we are in an industry and we recognize that. And of course, when you hear that a film has made the money invested, firstly, and then, of course, the profits. It's gratifying for the business of the cinema. When the film has appealed to your audience, it's extremely creatively satisfying. And that's what we as a team would always look for and seek. But when the reference is made to butterflies and nervousness, I get very gobsmacked about what kind of an answer to give, because I don't know whether saying, "Of course I get nervous," will humanize me, or saying that, "No, I mean, we have made the baby and the baby is out there to live its life, it's like let the birds fly." and it will live its life. It will find its journey, and hopefully the flight is a wonderful one. And that's what the team aspires. But beyond that, it's not about... it's never been about butterflies. So that's consistent from my last film to this.
After comical Piku, there is a intensive Talwar and now Jazba. So how do you opt for your script?
I just go by the instinct. You know, if the story pulls you, if the Jazba has been made by some other director, I would have definitely considered something else. But I know that, you know, what the director is capable of doing. So you rely on director, you rely on your, the way there's a bell which rings when you hear a script or when you hear your role. And that makes you decide, you know. And you also look at the producer, you know, whether he's going to put it, you know, present it properly or not. You know, all these considerations are there. But first and foremost, there should be a, you know, ting in your heart when you listen to the script, you know.
10 years, I think, since Z entered the world of Hindi cinema with the production, if I'm not wrong. The last film was Bhagmati. So what made you opt for this subject and as participant producers?
See, Z has entered cinema many times and with some success, some not so successful films. I personally made Gadar for Z, which Z backed some 10 years ago. Bhagmati was one of the animations. So we, as filmmakers, as a company, we keep on experimenting. And there were a lot of other films too, which were made. But now, when we saw the total environment of the business of cinema, and we saw the kind of things that are happening around, we decided to come in once again. And we were searching for something really as a first step. And when Sanjay narrated this story and we just got hooked on, and we thought this is exactly what we want to start with, and we are here to stay. We are looking at doing a lot more films, all types of films. Some will succeed and some won't, but that's fine. I think that's business.
Irfan sir, कैसा रहा सेट्स पे ऐश्वर्या जी के साथ काम करने का और आपका कैसा रहा अनुभव? दोनों लोग एक दूसरे का अनुभव बताएं और कोई ऐसा खास एक्सपीरियंस जो सेट पे हुआ?
मेरा एक रीजन इस फिल्म को करने का, ऐश्वर्या जी भी हैं बहुत बड़ा रीजन, और मैं आई वाज लुकिंग फॉरवर्ड एंड मेरे लिए उनको जानना, उनको देखना करीब से एंड उनका काम करने का एक जो तरीका है, और फिर इससे ज़्यादा एक्जिलेटिंग कुछ नहीं होता कि एक माँ अपने बच्चे का ध्यान रख रही है और साथ में शूट कर रही है. इट्स अ ब्यूटिफुल एक्सपीरियंस फॉर मी. एंड यस्टरडे वी जस्ट फिनिश्ड, यू नो, वी कंप्लीटेड द फिल्म एंड इट वॉज अ ब्यूटिफुल डे एंड इट वॉज अ ग्रेट एक्सपीरियंस. यू नो, इट्स अ काइंड ऑफ मेमोरी आई विल चेरिश. And I loved the experience.
आप भी कुछ बताएं कैसा रहा?
I have been saying it right from the word go. He asked me another question. I answered something else because, like I said, this was the dream cast for me. And I mean, when I read the script, it was him. And I'm so glad he came on board because it could have only been him. And it just made working every day so natural. It doesn't feel like work. You can see why. Like he said, the blessing Urf curse is wonderful. He just makes it, it's very relaxed. And yet you know you're there to do focus work as colleagues. We have him helming it. And again, even him, I mean, you know, when you're working even with Sanjay, I mean, here I kept saying that before, that here when you say Sanjay Gupta, you know, it's I'll use that term again, testosterone infused. I mean, there's a Sanjay Gupta movie. And you know, it was wonderful that he brought and evoked that energy out of us every day in such emotional and even intense moments, which just makes working together effortless. And he definitely brings that. I mean, Irfan really, really brings that out as a colleague. And like I said, you're a bad habit. In the way he says it, as it obviously a good habit. But he's a bad habit. And looking forward to, hopefully, directors willing, writers willing, many more experiences of working together. Truly.
Hi, how are you?
All good, thank you.
अच्छा ऐश्वर्या जी, हमें बताइए कि आपका ये एडवोकेट का रोल बॉलीवुड इंडस्ट्री में दूसरे एडवोकेट के रोल से कितना डिफरेंट है?
ये आपको हमें बताना होगा फिल्म देखने के बाद.
एंड टू इरफान सर, लाइक ऐश्वर्या जी का ये कमबैक है, तो आपको ऐसा लगेगा कि आप पूरे साइडलाइन हो जाएंगे इस फिल्म में?
मुझे एक तो उन्हें कमबैक नहीं लगता, मुझे तो एक यू नो मुझे कभी लगा ही नहीं कि वो कभी गई हैं कहीं. एंड साइडलाइन होने में कुछ अच्छी बुरी बात नहीं, अच्छा लगेगा वो. यू नो किससे साइडलाइन होना है, ऐश्वर्या का किससे साइडलाइन होना है तो अच्छी बात है, खूबसूरत बात है.
You know, you obviously are a very private person and you don't give too many interviews. We've seen over the years that, you know, you've kept yourself and you have a few, you have the Khan thing that happens and we have few things. But, you know, a lot of actors make sure that they are in the limelight, even if a movie is not there. You know, they are doing events, seen a lot of things. That doesn't happen. A, are you going to miss not doing that and keeping to yourself? B, also we spoke to Abhishek and he told that, you sometimes come on Twitter, but are you still going to keep yourself away from the social media and, you know, all that?
The social media question is to be answered that I'm not on it. I haven't been on it so far. And when I go, sometimes it's on his account and it'll be about sharing wishes and thanking, obviously, the millions of well-wishers for all their love and good wishes, which honestly I'm very, very grateful for. People have been so generous throughout. Another reason why I've just not felt the gap or the factor that I may not have been making movies. And I'm very, very grateful for the love. And I'll go on all your handles to say precisely that and share that with everybody, because I truly mean it. And I have all of you to convey that as well. So at every given opportunity of a media interaction, I pretty much obviously and genuinely will convey to all your readers, viewers and our well-wishers for all their love and blessings and good wishes and kudos and critiquing and the good and bad and the ugly, all that goes with the turf. When it comes to making sure that you're seen and being seen, again, I think it's not about, I've never been about any kind of, there's no plan to it, you know, there isn't any strategizing. I think I believe I pretty much am very present because, yeah, I do have a life. I mean, life is in the way and I live it as well. And I've always said that, you know, whether it meant making movies before marriage, during marriage, literally, after marriage, during my pregnancy, also more than half of it, I was definitely present in interacting with you all on various platforms, and after motherhood as well, from the third month, 3.5 months, and I was doing endorsements and appearances on that front. The reason I wasn't making movies is because I'm the kind of person who commits. I definitely respect the integrity of commitment, and I'm a very committed mother, and I'm a very committed professional, and I will not give less of myself to either aspect of my life. So when I felt it was time that I could now venture out to figure out the balance, I didn't know it. I was figuring out, I still am, I'll continue to, because life changes. And in a mother's life, I think every day is a first. Whether it's a one-year-old, three-year-old, five-year-old, you've never been a mother of a one-year-old, three-year-old or a five-year-old before. So every day and thereon, every day is a new day and you keep discovering what's in store in your everyday. But when I felt I was ready to be able to balance the prioritizing, that's when we went ahead. I mean, Gupta and me were kind of talking for more than what, six, eight months before that. He sent me the idea and he kept saying, let's meet. But his energy, and you know you're raring to go. Now, as a professional, like I said, once an artist, always an artist. We'll sit together. We're sitting right here and you're like raring to go completely. But life is in the way, you know. So when we were ready, there we were on the accelerator, kicking on all guns blast, as we'd say in his lingo, and ready to, you know, roll. And I'm glad we did when we did, because it all just seems right. It all fell in place.
Sure. Irfan, you know, when we see the trailer, we also noticed an observation is that there's a lot of hero bazi, the term, if you can say it. Like, you play beautiful characters, and, you know, then there's, like, you know, in a Shah Rukh and a Salman, you have this certain hero stardom to it when they do it with a certain thing. This movie kind of puts you in that zone which you usually are not, you know, you obviously are a fantastic actor. Have you enjoyed doing that? Have you enjoyed playing the hero kind of way?
I don't think it put me in that zone. My zone is my zone, and I won't, I'll keep expanding my zone. You know, that's what the fun is. You cannot put yourself into somebody else's zone. Everybody creates their own zone. And I loved it, you know, because it's a solid character. And there is a solid undercurrent, you know, the kind of chemistry, the kind of relationship my character and Aishwarya's character is having. It's unseen, you know, you haven't seen this kind of, you know, chemistry. I loved those one-liners, you know. The first day of the shoot, I asked Sanjay, he was directing me, and that Amitabh Bachchan wala scene. I said, one-liners kahan hain? And then he started narrating me one after the other, and I loved it. And that was my, you know, something I was propelled by. I said, "Mujhe do bolo one-liner. I want to say them." So you enjoy.
He can say them the way he does. When you see the film, you know that. I'm telling you, this—it's an art. It's an art.
हमने सुना है कुछ singing debut भी किया है आपने इस film से. Is it true? कुछ गाना भी गाया है आपने इस film में.
मैं बताता हूँ अभी तक नहीं. But intention है.
तो ऐश्वर्या कुछ इरादा हमें इस फिल्म में या इन फ्यूचर हमें कुछ गाने आपके जुबान से सुनने को मिलेंगे बिकॉज पिछले कुछ एक सालों
फिलहाल जज्बा के बारे में बात करते हैं फ्यूचर के प्लान्स फ्यूचर में ही बात कर लेते हैं
बिकॉज पिछले कुछ एक सालों में कई सारे एक्टर ने गाना भी गाया है लाइक आलिया भट्ट प्रियंका चोपड़ा श्रद्धा कपूर सलमान खान
काफी सालों से एक्टर्स हैव संग इट्स जस्ट प्रोबेबली मे बी द इट्स नॉट अ न्यू थिंग एक्टर्स हैव बीन सिंगिंग फॉर आई मीन has been singing forever so okay. It's not a hali mein log actors are singing it's probably getting obviously a lot more it's we're trying to probably do what's natural to everybody anyways and like I said we all sing aap bhi gaate hain aap bhi gaate hain aap bhi gaate hain because we've all loved our cinema music I think there's a singer in every one of us it's about choosing to go on and explore it's just about the choice to be made as and when you choose to do it so there is no time frame to that as to ki ab ye ho raha hai aur pehle nahi ho raha tha aisi koi baat nahi hai pehle bhi ho raha tha
mere liye to inke samne khada hona mushkil tha to wo mushkil thoda dheere dheere ease out ho gayi because inhone ease kar diya usko that was the toughest thing
Aishwarya on your left Aishwarya hamare ऐश्वर्य हमारे इंडस्ट्री में हमेशा ऐसी बातें हैं कि जो दिखता है वो बिकता है तो काफी पिछले कुछ एक सालों में
आप सब हंस रहे थे ना पहले ही कि अभी पता है ऐसा कोई सवाल आने वाला है
तो, पिछले कुछ एक सालों में एज एन एक्टर क्या फील करती हैं कि ऐश्वर्या राय की पॉपुलरिटी में कुछ एक कमी आई है या उनकी पॉपुलरिटी वैसे भी है जैसे पिछले कुछ एक पाँच सालों में
मैं ना कोई ट्रैकिंग कंपनी हूँ ना मैं कोई एनालिसिस आई एम एन एक्टर यार आई एम एन एक्टर एंड आई एम हियर टू डू माय जॉब ये सब आप कीजिए
माय क्वेश्चन टू यू इज रिगार्डिंग योर रोल हाउ डिफिकल्ट वाज इट फॉर यू टू पोर्ट्रे अ ट्रॉमेटाइज्ड मदर हु इज अबाउट टू लूज हर डॉटर एंड देन स्विचिंग ऑफ टू अ कन्विंसिंग लॉयर
It's kind of the job of an actor, no? I mean, this is something that we're meant to do. And we're in the able hands of the director every day on set. And with very committed, responsible colleagues. And this is what we do every day. I mean, how difficult or how convincing. Every day at work is challenging. I mean, I think the word is difficult, the word is challenging, and that's what we as artists look forward to. I think if it was just a blind walk in the park, then what do you wake up and go to? What would excite you? So you're looking forward for that challenge that excites you, that, like he was saying about feeling that bell inside, it has to ring close. You know, it has to excite you, it has to evoke something to want for you to be there and taking time out from your reality, you know, we're not leading our personal lives and coming every day to work. This is not a conventional 9-to-5 job. The job of us as artists is, in fact, very rarely defined by time. We know what time we arrive at shoot. We never know what time we're necessarily going back. because we are about there getting the moment captured. And even if life is in the way, very often we are like, okay, so when do you think we'll wrap? And very often we are about adjusting our life around that. And the only reason we do that is because we love what we do. Why else would we do that on a daily basis? So as long as we are feeling that feeling, we are there making that movie and doing that part. In terms of whether you're playing a mother, you're playing a lawyer, you're playing whatever different roles you have out there, that's what we need to bring to the table. And like you said, that's why we're there doing that job. It's our job to do that. It's our professional commitment to do just that.
So on a music perspective, can you throw some light on what the audience can expect from Just by the Stand?
Personally, for me, the music making part is the most exciting part about my movies. I love that whole process, and there's no way I could even think of a film without music in it. But having said that, this is not your conventional formula film, and these characters cannot suddenly break into a jig and they cannot start singing songs. So we are not doing that. Yeah, there's no party song in the film. So we don't have that, but yes, we do have an OST, and there will be songs which we're working on, which would be there for the in the OST to promote the film.
I love and respect that. We're not, again, while he obviously stated it, I think we all sit here and have that factor and commonality that we don't necessarily need to play into obvious conventional perception of the adages that necessarily go with the perception of what to expect.
Hi, I have a question for the cast and the director. Of course, it's slightly away from Jazba, but hear me out. If you feel like responding to it, you can. Basically, recently, there was this infidelity website which was hacked, and the clients of which were majorly Indians. I would just write want a reaction from each of you.
I think this question...
I wouldn't want to react to that.
The photographers, I think you all can...
Media,
request everyone to please stand up. We'd request the photographers to please come up and take...
Kya, wo infidelity kya?
I don't know kya tha. I don't even know.
इसीलिए जो है लोगों ने अभी इस बात को इतना उठाया नहीं क्योंकि ऑडियंस के लिए अलग अलग चॉइस है और ये साल वैसे भी बहुत इंटरेस्टिंग रहा है मेरे लिए पीकू से लेके जुरासिक पार्क के दिनों बिल्कुल अलग अलग किस्म की फिल्म है तलवार है जज्बा है जो एक कम्प्लीटली अलग तरह की फिल्म है तो क्योंकि ये एक्सपीरियंस अलग है दोनों कहानियों का इंटेंशन ऑडियंस को डिफरेंट किस्म का एक्सपीरियंस देने का है ही इज एन सस्पेंडेड पुलिस ऑफिसर एंड उस पर चार्जेस हैं कुछ वो कितने सीरियस हैं वो यू नो पता नहीं चलता and he thinks that he's in crisis and then there is a chemistry between him and Aishwarya and but there is another story which is going on which he doesn't know and when he comes to know then there is a kind of blast in the film you know, story wise
about Aishwarya tell something more about the chemistry between you and Aishwarya
it was fantastic you know she's a very very interesting woman, nice personality, And she has so much of warmth, simplicity, eager to work, and you know, beautiful. And it was outstanding, you know, chemistry. You know, I loved every moment of that. पहले प्रोड्यूस की थी मैंने, उसमें मैंने काम किया था, बट इस बार उनके खुद के डायरेक्शन में किया है. एंड क्योंकि उनका अपना कहानी सुनाने का अंदाज होता है, उनका अपना पर्टिकुलर लुक होता है, ही इज़ वेरी पर्टिकुलर अबाउट दैट एंड ही नोज वॉट ही वॉन्ट्स. सो यू नो, कभी कभी एक्टर को अच्छा लगता है कि आपको पता है कि डायरेक्टर का एक खाका है, एक यू नो देयर इज अ सिस्टम, देयर इज अ काइंड ऑफ you know, story telling he believes in, and then you come and you try to make things, you know, you add something to it and you take some things from them, and then there is a kind of, you know, interesting combination between the two, the dynamics which have been created through this you know, marriage.
Two international stars in film.
Ji.
So was it difficult for him to
No, I think we both believed in his storytelling, and we know that where he's coming from. We know that he has a particular way of telling a story, and we accepted his film. So we were already, you know, ready to be directed by him.
बहुत सारे
नहीं, हाँ बहुत सारे हैं एक्चुअली. मैं उसी के लिए एक बहुत बड़ा अट्रैक्शन था मेरा वो इस फिल्म को करने का. एंड those dialogues are not just time pass, you know, this there's certain dialogues which will stay with you, you know. Like mujhe kai baar lagta hai ki Sanjay Gupta shayad mujhe mere liye unhone likha hai ye line ki yaar tum ek tarah ki film karte rehte ho, tum ab ye wali karo, aur uske liye main aapko ek line de raha hu ki sharafat ki duniya ka qissa hi khatam, jaisi duniya waise hum. To you know, to aisa uske kai maayne bhi nikalte hain unki lines ke. शुरू किया है और अभी मुझे मेरी तरह की कहानियाँ मिल रही हैं, और अभी तो शुरुआत, मुझे लग रहा है कि मेरी शुरुआत है, तो मैं अभी इसको किसी तरह से, और मैं पूरी तरह सेटिस्फाइड हूँ जो हो रहा है, और मुझे मज़ा आ रहा है, बहुत एंगेज्ड हूँ. वो तब होता है कि आपने कुछ यू नो अंदर बचा रह जाता है, और आपको लगता है कि यार इस चीज़ से पूरा नहीं हो रहा, और मुझे जो है कुछ और इख्तियार करना पड़ेगा अपने आप को एंगेज रखने के लिए. जैसे जब मैं टेलीविज़न में था तो मुझे डायरेक्ट करने का मुझे ज़रूरत महसूस हुई थी, इसीलिए क्योंकि मैं एक्टिंग से कुछ बोर हो रहा था. तो अभी ऐसा नहीं है, अभी यस डेफिनेटली मैं आई वुड लव टू प्रोड्यूस समथिंग यू नो विच आई हैव बीन डूइंग फ्यू फिल्म्स, एंड आई एम रियली ईगरली वेटिंग फॉर समबडी who has money and who can believe in my vision and who's interested in creating you know a variety of entertainment for people, you know, like which is happening nowadays, you know, there are films which engages you intellectually, you know, or emotionally, but you know, audience is demanding different kind of experience, and that's the reason why at one hand typical commercial film, at other hand there's a film based on an issue, both are you know, very successfully.
Talking about promoting the film, recently a tweet aaya tha Sanjay Gupta sir ka ki ji sometimes jo promotions hote they are overrated, so as an actor what do you feel about it, what will you think?
I think it's a very important point, and it's a very important thing to be considered by the film industry, that you know the amount of money we spend on promotion is obnoxious and it doesn't help filmmaking. It's a burden on filmmaking. We should have a cap on that, and we should you know, reduce that amount. Sometimes you know it's the ratio is 1:1, and it's a waste of money. You know, it's a criminal waste of money, because the film suffers, because the director who's making a good film, just because he has to spend so much, or producer has to spend so much of money on publicity, the burden comes on the film, and then you know the director or actor's work is judged by the business what the film is doing, and you don't understand that you know it's such a big chunk of budget is being taken by publicity, which sometimes we don't know how it's translating into the business of the film, audience actually, you know, when audience is just that, you know, you have to make people aware that this film is coming. Audience decides on trailer. Audience watch the trailer and they decide, you know, which film to watch, which film not to watch. You know, all what we are doing is, you know, we are just filling your space. I don't know how many people will come to watch this film because of this. And this interview will be watched maybe, you know, after 6 months from now on. You know, how it is going to affect the film, I don't think there's anything to do with the film. It's just the awareness that, you know, you have to create the awareness, and the trailer does the main thing, you know. He's apt, he's correct, what he's saying.
Talking about the trailer of the film, humne sabne trailer dekha film ka. Saath, aap dono ke saath mein film mein aur bhi Diggaj kar rahe hain. Jackie Shroff.
Bilkul, haan, Shabana Azmi hai.
Aur kaisa aapka experience?
Mere bahut logon ke saath scene nahi hai. मेरे ज़्यादातर उस समय ऐश्वर्या जी के साथ सीन है, एक उनके साथ शबाना आजमी के साथ बहुत अच्छे सीन है कुछ, और बहुत लोगों के साथ मेरा इंट्रैक्शन नहीं है फिल्म में, बट सब बहुत अच्छे हैं, दे आर ऑल एडिंग टू द फिल्म एंड द वंडरफुल एक्टर्स.
संजय गुप्ता अगेन, हमने देखा है फिल्म में एक अलग ही टेक्सचर रहता है उनका.
हाँ,
कांटे देखे हैं, जिंदा देखे इस फिल्म में भी थोड़ा. तो व्हाट आर योर व्यूज?
आई थिंक वो जिस तरह की कहानी चूज करते हैं उसके लिए एक अपने किस्म की दुनिया बनाना उनके लिए ज़रूरी है, और वो जो है लोगों को एक अपनी कहानियों की दुनिया में यू नो ट्रांसपोर्ट करते हैं, तो इसके लिए उनका अपना एक लुक जो है वो पर्टिकुलर होता है और वो क्रिएट करते हैं उस लुक को.
सर, आपको बहुत से लोगों ने सवाल पूछा होगा आप रोमांटिक फिल्में क्यों नहीं करते या करना चाहेंगे, आपने भी कहा?
मैं करता हूँ कभी कभी, जब मौका मिलता है करता हूँ, जितना मौका मिलेगा उतना ही करूँगा. पीकू मेरे लिए रोमांटिक थी, लंच बॉक्स भी मेरे लिए रोमांटिक थी, नेमसेक भी रोमांटिक थी, मकबूल रोमांटिक थी. तो कम टाइम चांस मिलता है लोगों को शायद, लेकिन अब मुझे लगता है पीपल आर अवेयर एंड दे आर ऑफरिंग मी रोमांटिक रोल्स एंड आई विल चूज एंड आई लव आई वुड लव टू डू रोमांटिक फिल्म्स. यस,
तो फाइनली व्यूअर्स को क्या कहना चाहेंगे इन शॉर्ट अबाउट जज़्बा?
बी हैप्पी, एंजॉय द लाइफ एंड यू नो बी अवेयर एंड हैव अ ग्रेट टाइम. Without on not on somebody else's expenses, you know, just have a good time and create a good world.
Superb. Thank you, sir. Thank you so much.
Thank you. Thank you.